Now left hand side you have negative number 2060. If you take that to right hand side, becomes plus. Yes or no?
Yes.
So 2000 gets cancelled.
Yes.
60 subtracted from 196. You'll still have 136. Subtract 136 from this number. 9720. 180 into root x is equal to this much. Yeah, 0 0 cancel. 18 how many times? 5 times and then 4 times. So root x is equal to 54. Answer should be 54 square. Right. Answer should be 54 square. 54 is how much more? Answer should end with 6 first of all. How many options are there? 2 are there. 3 are there. Okay. 54 is how much more than 50? 4 square. So answer should end with 16?
Yes.
Over. You understand that point, right?
Yes.
61 square should end with? Me paade. Last 2 digits. 21. Yes or no? 61 is how much more than 50? 11 square. Last 2 digits? 21. Now 59 square should end with 59 is how much more than 50? 9 square.
81.
So answer should end with
81.
Now 72 square should end with 84. 72 is how much more than 50? 22. 22 square. Last 2 digits 84. Right. With that logic we are identifying 2916. Next. So in numerator you have 3 numbers and denominator you have only 2 numbers. Let's identify number after decimal. Here, number after decimal. How many numbers are there? 5. And in denominator? 6. Denominator? 6. So, after writing these numbers, you'll still have to multiply your number with 10. Because in numerator there are only 5 numbers after decimal, but in denominator you have 6 digits. So it becomes 80 into 1 into 72 by 12 into 4. 4, 20 times, 12, 6 times, 20 into 6, 120. Come on. Last digit is enough. 2, 32, 34. From that you have to subtract 76. So let it be 134 minus 76. Answer should end with 58.58. First option. Right. 11.6, that is very clear. Keep it like this. This value. Denominator? Hey, pade, matladu chavandi. Denominator, 0.464. What is 10 times of denominator? 4.64. What is 20 times? 9.28. So what is value of this? 20. You already have 11.6 and we need to add 20. Now, this value. Can I take this number as 28.28 divided by 7? I'm multiplying numerator and denominator with 100. So this becomes 4.04. We have to subtract it. Yes or no? 60 minus 0.04. 60 minus 0.04. 0.56. Over. 0.60, 0.04. You are just verifying only number after decimal. Point 0.2 square, 0.04 plus 0.01, that is 0.05. 0.1 into 0.1, 0.01 plus 0.02, that is total 0.03. If you take only numbers, 5 into 3, 15. But in first number, number after decimals, 2. Number after decimal, 2. Total you should have 4. So let's write 2 more zeros and keep decimal. 0.0015. Under root 225 by under root 27. We can write it as 5 by 9. So let me write it as 5 by 9 minus under root 25 by, now this value divided by 4 by 9, divided by 4 by 9 can be written as into 9 by 4. Just a minute. In number decimal, in numbers in bracket, can we take 5 common?
Yes.
That will be there in numerator?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Do we have any 5 multiple in denominator?
No.
Then 5 multiple should be there in numerator itself?
Yes.
You are done with your answer. 5 by 16. When you take 5 common in number inside bracket, numerator should be 9 multiple because there are no 5 multiples in denominator. Next. Take minus 184, right hand side number to left hand side, that becomes plus 184. Plus 184 plus 7.52. Let me add that. 191.52. And then you still have 252% of 724. 250% plus 2%. Yes? 200% in the sense 2 times of the number? Which is equal to 14? 48. What is 50% half? 362. What is 1%? 7.24. 2%? 14.48. Number after decimal, 0.52, 0.48. You'll get 1. So 1 carry. 1 plus 1 plus 8, 10. 10 plus 2 plus 4, 16. You still have 1 carry. Come on. 4, 6, 10. 9 plus 1, 10. And then you still have 1. That is total 21. Are you getting? Next. 2 plus 1 plus 3 plus 4, 10. 0. And then 1. That is total value 2016. Now you need to identify 2016 is what percent of 2400. Yes or no? What is 10% of 2400? 240. What is 20%? 480. Suppose if you subtract 480, you know that you will get 80%. How much is that? 1920. Are you getting? But your number should be 2016. That means you still need to add 96. Am I right?
Yes,
yes or no? 96. What is 1% of 2400? 24. 96 is equal to how many 24s? 4. That means 84% is this much. Over. Next, I'll tell you one more thing here. 2016 is what percent of 2400? Now, not exactly last digit, 4 into 4 ends with 6, 4 into 9 ends with 6, there is only 1, 84. Yeah, last digit is one way, last digit verification you can do, but left hand side you have 9 multiple. Yes? Right hand side you have only 3 multiple. That means your x must be which multiple?
3 multiple.
How many 3 multiples are there? 2. 84, 78. There is only 1 3 multiple, you need not to verify it. And the best way is last digit verification. That also is possible. Next. This is not division, this is plus. The last one is plus. 1.8 into 33.5. That means 2 times minus 0.2 times will give you 1.8 times? 2 times of 33.5? 67. From this you have to subtract 6.7. 2 times is 67. You need to subtract 0.2 times. That will be 6.7. Correct? How much is that? 60.3. Now you have to calculate this value, and again you need to add 143.25. Yes or no? Now 2.8 into 7.25. Can you write 7.25 as 7 1 by 4?
Yes.
7 1 by 4 in the sense 29 by 4?
Yes.
2.8 into 29 by 4. 4 how many times? 0.7. Take 7 times first, then you can calculate 0.7 times. Okay? Right. 7 times of 29. 7 times of 30 minus 1 time of 7?
Yes.
7 times of 30?
Yes.
Minus 7? 203. So, if 7 times is 203, 0.7 times will be
20.3.
Number after decimal should be 0.85. There is only one option, 223.85. Second option. Next. If I have to solve this, I'll skip. Because you have to calculate x value, but x value is mixed fraction. Look at your options. X is mixed fraction. Obviously, it takes time. Okay? Right. So, anyway, come on. 5 1 by 3 in the sense 16 by 3 minus 3 2 by 3 in the sense 11 by 3 divided by 1 1 by 3 in the sense divided by 4 by 3 coming divided by 4 by 3 can be written as into 3 by 4, and you need to calculate x value. Divided by x in the sense into 1 by x is equal to 429 by 96. So to calculate this, 4 into 96 plus 29 by 96, correct? Now in place of 96, if you have 100, that will be easy to simplify it.
Yes.
Now you have to multiply 4 with 96. To make it round figure, we need to add 4 to 96. After that, we have to multiply it with what number? Me pada meeru kumbala kumbal tinamante tintar vachi answer cheppamante sastunnar. To make it round figure, you need to add 4. After adding 4, you have to multiply that number with what number? With
4.
Chachar randi, come on, calculate 4 times of 96. నాకు వచ్చి నన్ను రాయమంటే డైరెక్ట్ నంబరే రాస్తా, 3. అండ్ దిస్ టు దిస్ నెంబర్ యూనిట్ యాడ్ 29. కమ్ ఆన్ యాడ్ 4 1 3. ఓకే, సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 413 బై 96. నౌ 3 3 గెట్స్ క్యాన్సిల్. నౌ 11 బై 4 ఎక్స్, లెఫ్ట్ హ్యాండ్ సైడ్ నెగిటివ్ నెంబర్ ఈజ్ 11 బై 4 ఎక్స్. టేక్ దట్ టు రైట్ హ్యాండ్ సైడ్, that becomes positive number, 11 by 4x. Take 413 by 96 to left hand side, that becomes minus 413 by 96. You have 16 by 3 here, but denominator I am expecting 96, so you have to multiply both numerator and denominator with 32 into 3, denominator value 96. First of all, this is fixed. Numerator 32 into 16, yes or no? 32 can be written as 2 into 16. Into 16 we have 2 into 16 square, 256 into 2, 512 minus 413, 99 by 96. 11 how many times? 9 times. 11, 9 times. 4 how many times? 24 times. So 1 by x is equal to 9 by 24, x is equal to 24 by 9, 9 2 times 18, 6 by 9 in the sense 2 by 3. 2 2 by 3, first option. మీలో అక్కడక్కడ తెలివిగల వాళ్ళు ఉండుండొచ్చు, వాళ్ళ కోసం ఒకటి చెప్తా వినండి. 4 × 96 + 29 / 96, ఇది మనం రైట్ హ్యాండ్ సైడ్ నెంబర్ క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేయాల్సింది. ఎక్కువసార్లు చెప్పను, ఒకేసారి చెప్తా, చిరాగ్గా ఉన్నా. 96 రౌండ్ ఫిగర్ అవ్వాలంటే 4 యాడ్ చేయాలి, దాని తర్వాత మళ్ళీ 4తో మల్టిప్లై చేయాలి, అంటే 16 కావాలి. ఆ 16 పక్క నెంబర్ నుంచి తీసుకుంటాను, పక్క నెంబర్లో 13 మిగులుద్ది, ముందు 400 అవుతుంది, మొత్తం 413 అవుద్ది. అర్థం కానాలి, లైట్ తీసుకోండి. నెక్స్ట్ కమాన్. సో హియర్ ఐ జస్ట్ కాన్సన్ట్రేట్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్టర్ డెసిమల్. ఓకే, 0.017, 0.617, 0.170. నౌ లాస్ట్ 2 డిజిట్స్ ఆల్సో ఎన్ ఆఫ్ ఐ గెస్. లాస్ట్ 2 డిజిట్ 17 17, 34 34 70 104. ఆన్సర్ షుడ్ ఎండ్ విత్ 04. లాస్ట్ 2 డిజిట్స్ షుడ్ ఎండ్ విత్ 04. ఫైనల్ ఆన్సర్. ఓ, రెండు ఉన్నాయా? ఆల్రైట్, దెన్ దిస్ కెనాట్ బి ద వన్. Because you, no, because you already have 6 and 1, right? How can it be 5? So this cannot be the one answer final. Already you see 600 and then 100. It cannot be 500. Should be more than 700 or equal to 700. So fifth cannot be the one, third final answer. Next, you want me to discuss this? Sure? Right. Set A contains 6 consecutive odd numbers and their average is 76. 6 consecutive odd numbers. Average is 76. So that will be in between third number and fourth number, correct? Right. This is set A. Next. There are 6 consecutive even numbers in set B. And the lowest number of set B is 33 less than highest number of set A. Now you have to calculate highest number of set A. Now, if middle number is 76, next immediate number becomes? Next odd number? Largest odd number? Now, least number in set B is 33 less than 81. 33 less than 81? 48. Now, your question is to identify average of set B. Average will be middle number like this. Next even number for 48. Next even number. Next immediate number. 53. You know, average is middle number. That means in between 52 and 54. Or else directly you can add 5 to this number, minimum number. Minimum number plus 5 will give you middle number. Or largest number minus 5 will give you middle number. Ana kada? Right. 87. If it takes 16 men working 9 hours a day, 28 days to finish a piece of work. 16 men, 9 hours, takes 28 days to complete the work. How many more men working 6 hours a day will be required to finish the same piece of work in 12 days? So now we need to have extra men. That means 16 plus 6 will be working for 6 hours a day. And how many days they are working? 12 hours, 12 days. Per day they are working 6 hours. Now, just a minute. This is enough to answer the question. You don't have to do it. 28 is 7 multiple. Right hand side, do we have 7 multiples here? That means 16 plus x must be 7 multiple. Take first option, 30 plus 16. 30 plus 16. Is 46 7 multiple?
No.
Next, 42 plus 16? 58. 58. Is 58 7 multiple?
No.
36 plus 16? 52. Is 52 7 multiple?
No.
38 plus 16? 54. Is 54 7 multiple?
No.
40 right answer. You don't have to check it. Yes. Next. If the cost price of a mobile phone is 66% of its selling price, that means if selling price is 100, cost price becomes 66. How much profit is made 34 out of cost price 66 percentage into 100. Now what is 50% of denominator? Your numerator is how much more? One more. Yes or no? What is 1% of denominator? 0.66. That means your final answer is more than 51%. How many options are there? How many options are there? Three options are there. Yes or no? But what is your denominator? 60. Then your answer denominator should be factor of 66. This is not a factor, this is not a factor. 31 is not factor of 66. 35 is not factor of 66. 33 is factor. Hence 51, 17 by 33. This is your final answer. You understand? Sure? Everybody, your denominator should be factor of your original denominator. Your original denominator is 66. Are you getting? Right. If the cost price of 22 shirts and 4 trousers is 9,654, what is the total price of 55 shirts and 35 trousers? Now, sometimes answer can be determined, sometimes answer cannot be determined. When can you get your answer? If increase or decrease in number of shirts and in number of trousers is in same proportionate, then we will get answer, correct? Now, how many shirts are there initially? What is half of 22? 11 into which number will give you 55? 5. That means what is that we are doing? Divided by 2 into 5 for number of shirts. If the same is applicable for number of trousers also, the same you have to apply to get your answer, correct? Now, half of number of trousers given in data? 7. 7 into 5? Is your question is also having 35 trousers? So answer also divided by 2. Just a minute. How do you calculate 5 times of a number? Divided by 2, 10 times. Yes or no? Already you have to divide number with 2. Again, after that you have to multiply it with 5. So in 5 multiplication we follow like 10 by 2. There also you have divided by 2. That means 2 division is done for how many times? That means direct division with?
4.
Come on, tell me, divided by 4. 2, 4, 1. Aipoyindi inkenduku mee paade meeru. You should see 2, 4, 1. There is only one option. Why do you need other number? You know that you will still get something. But why do I care of it when there is only one option? Clear? Next. A wheel makes 23 revolutions to cover a distance of 4594. What is the diameter of the wheel? Okay, now, if it is covering some distance, what is the distance that it cover for one revolution? Perimeter? Yes or no? That means 22 by 7 into. Your question is to identify diameter, right?
Yes.
So instead of 2 pi r, can we take it as pi d?
Yes.
22 by 7 into d into? This is for one revolution. But how many revolutions are made? 23. And this is the distance that it is going to cover for 23 revolutions. And which is given as 4,554. Is it clear? Come on. Right hand side number, that is 9 multiple? Matladru. Left hand side numerator, do you have any 9 multiple?
No.
Then D must be 9 multiple?
Yes.
How many 9 multiples are there? Over, done. You already know the diameter should be which multiple? 7 multiple. Apply that rule, you see 3 options. 77, 70, 63. Okay, so because of right hand side number 4554, that is 9 multiple, D must be 9 multiple. There is only 163 final answer. Okay, na ledante kotteskunta kuchovali mee ishtam adi. Anyway, next. If a sum of money doubles itself in 6 years, what will be the rate of interest? Now, Sum becomes doubles itself. If I lend 100% from you, in return how much should I give you back? 200%. That means how much interest I am adding? In how many years? Per year, that is 1/6 of 100%. What do you mean by 1/6? 16 by 3%. Fourth option answer. Clear? Next. A train 362.5 meters long is running at a speed of 79 km per hour. In what time will it cross a man running at 8 km per hour? In the direction opposite to that in which the train is running. Okay. Now, if a train crosses a man, distance covered in that case? Amma? That is 362.5. Now you are asked to calculate time. Time t is equal to distance by speed. Both are running opposite to each other. Relative speed becomes s1. So 79 plus 8. 87 kilometer per hour. Convert it to meter per second. Into 5 by 18. Okay. Now, just a minute. Look at your numerator. 18. 18 is 9 multiple. Look at your denominator. Denominator first number is 87. Is that 9 multiple?
No.
That is only?
Three.
So you will have 3 multiple in numerator?
Yes.
Yes or no? Right. How many 3 multiples are there? How many are there?
Two.
Huh?
Two.
There is only 1. Don't look at 18. 18 is 9 multiple. But you know that your answer should be only 3 multiple. Yes or no?
Yes.
Right. Answer is 15. Final answer. Here, this is not 3 multiple. 362.5 is not a multiple of 3. 18 is 9 multiple. In denominator, you have 1 3 multiple. So, 9 multiple by 3 multiple, answer should be only 3 multiple. 18 is 9 multiple, so that cannot be the one. Answer 15. Final answer. Not satisfied? I'll give you one more logic here. Come here. Numerator first number. 362.5. Yes or no? There you have 25 multiple. Yes or no? And denominator you have only 1 5 multiple. So answer should be 5 multiple again. Should be 5 multiple and 3 multiple. There is only 115. Yes. Inka ardham galedante kotteskunta kuchotme. Inka antaku minchi nenaithe em cheyalenu. Right. Next. Karan invested sudden sum of money in scheme A for 6 years. After 6 years he occurred a simple interest of 6,960. Had the rate of interest been 2% more, how much more interest he could have occurred in 6 years? Right. Now, in 6 years you are just given simple interest, 6,960. Do you know principle? Do you know rate of interest? But you know simple interest for 6 years. Using that you can calculate 1 year interest only. On what principle? No one knows. And what is the rate of interest? No one knows. But if the rate of interest increases by 2% for 6 years, interest increases by 12%. 12% of what? Principle. That is not given. Will you calculate answer? Can we get answer? No. Answer can be done using two ways. If you are given principal, then you can directly calculate 12% of principal and add that to existing simple interest, 6,960 plus 12% of principal. Yes or no? If you know only rate of interest, will you get answer? Principal is not given, but rate of interest is given. Will you get answer? Yes. Yes, you will get. For 6 years, if rate of interest offered is 8%, for example, at the rate of 8% for 6 years interest is 6,960. Now rate of interest increased by 2%, which is 1/4 of 8%. So right hand side also will just add 1/4. That's it. So if you know rate of interest or if you know principal. If you know principal, 6,960. Plus 12% of principal we will add. Because per year rate of interest increasing by 2%. For 6 years, 12%. Clear? Right. So for this question actually, answer is cannot be determined. Next. Two taps A and B can individually fill a tank in 15 hours and 20 hours respectively. A, B. 15 hours. Come on, come on, come on, come on. 20 hours. LCM? 60. So A can fill 4 units. B can fill 3 units. Now, tap A was open. And after 4 hours, tap B was also open. How long did it take to fill the tank? Now, is A and B working from the beginning till end of the work?
No.
Who is missing?
B.
B is missing. For how many hours?
4 hours.
If B was there for those 4 hours also, B would alone can complete 12 units. Yes or no?
Yes.
So let me add 12 units to total work. That means I am adding 4 hours work of B. Yes or no? Now how many units we have total? 72. Now can I divide that with both A and B together?
Yes.
Yes, A and B together can complete 7 units. 72 by 7, 10 2 by 7. You got it? Other way is, for first 4 hours, who worked? A alone worked. A alone can complete 4 units per hour. In 4 hours, A alone can complete 16, remaining 44. Now to complete 44 units, who all are working? Both A and B are working. Both A and B will do 7 units together. To complete 44 by 7, they need 6, 2 by 7. The total time they need is 10, 2 by 7. Okay? Right. Now what we are doing is, initial total work is 60 units. B is missing for 4 hours. So you cannot divide 60 with 7 because B is not there for 4 hours. Hence I am adding B's 4 hours work, which is 12. 72 by 7, 10, 2 by 7. Got it? Next. A sum of 366 was divided among A, B, C so that A got half as much as B and C. That means if B and C together gets 2 parts, A will get half of that. That is only 1 part. Sum of A, B, C together is equal to how many parts? 3 parts. And A is getting 1 part. That means 1/3 of total? 1/3 of total? Right. A sum of 366. That means total is 366. A value is divided by 3. How much is that? Over. What is the share of A? You got it? Sure, everybody? Right. Now in the same question, if you are asked about B, B gets 2/3 as much as A and C. That means if A and C together gets 3 parts, B gets 2 parts. So B gets 2 parts out of 5 parts. 2 out of 5 in the sense 40%?
Yes.
What is 10%? 36.6. Forget about 0.6. We'll consider that later. 36 double? 72 double? And now consider 0.6. 0.6 double? 1.2. 1.2 double? 2. That means B gets 146.4. Got it? And you also know A is getting 122. Add these two values, subtract it from total, you'll get C amount. Next. Of the two numbers, 4 times the smaller number is less than 3 times the larger by 5. 4 times of smaller number is smaller than 3 times of big number by 5. Correct? Matladaru. Can I take this as 4x minus 3y is equal to minus 5? Yes? Next. If the sum of numbers, that means x plus y. What is small number here? Big number? Difference is? Y minus x. Sum of numbers is greater than 6 times of difference y minus x by 6. Now, right hand side, you have minus 6x, Take minus 6x to your left hand side, that becomes plus 6x plus 6. That is 7x. Right hand side you have plus 6y, take that to left hand side, minus 6y. Y minus 6y? Minus 5 is equal to how much? 6. As you need to calculate larger number, you have to eliminate x. So multiply first equation with 7, second equation with 4. Subtract first equation from second equation. Subtract first from second. Are you getting my point? This gets cancelled. Second equation, minus 5y into 4, minus 20y. Minus of minus, plus 3 into 7, 21. 21 minus 20, y. 6 into 4, 24. Minus 5 into 7, minus 35. Minus of minus, plus 35. What is that? 59. Nothing is there. You have to solve the equation and get the value. Next. What is the ratio between total number of employees from the organization together? Some data is missing. Data missing. I mean, data analysis. Forget about it. Forget about 97 and 98. In a competitive exam, there are 5 papers. The average score of Ramesh in first 3 papers is 76. And his average score in last 3 papers is 72. If his average score for all papers is 73, what is the score of the third number? Is it third paper repeat or third paper missing? If it is repeat case, number, is it direct effect or reverse? That means if average is more, you have to add. If average is less, subtract. What is average of all the numbers? So, marks in third paper is also 73. Now, first 3 papers average? 76. Which is how much more than actual average? 3 more. Like that, how many numbers are there? That means 3 threes, 9 more. Direct effect, so you have to add. And average of last 3 numbers is 72. 72 is 1 less than actual average. Like that there are 3 numbers. 1 into 3, 3 less. Answer? 79. Okay now? Yes. I'll tell you one more thing here. To this number either you have to add something or subtract something. You know average of first 3 numbers? And you also know average of last 3 numbers? So you will observe the change in average, either to add or subtract. You will observe the change in average, either to add, maybe subtract. After that you have to multiply it with 3. And in second case also you have to multiply it with 3. So multiplying number with 3 is common. Keep it aside. First 3 numbers average? Which is how much more? 3 more. Concentrate that. 3 more. Last 3 numbers average is 72. That is 1 less. 3 more. 1 less. Final. 2 more. Into 3. Got it? It's up to you. Whatever the way you follow. Next. A started a business by investing 24,000. After 4 months, B and C joined with an amount of 16,000, 28,000. They earned an annual profit of 46,780. What was B's share? Right. Now, look at here. A invested 24, B invested 16, C invested 28. A started, so he'll be there for 12 months. B and C joined after 4 months, so they'll be there for cancellation with 8, 3 times. Cancellation with 4, 3 times, 4 times, 7 times. That means 9 parts, 4 parts, 7 parts. Total? Total 20 parts is equal to 46,780. Now you need to calculate B's share, that is equal to 4 parts. See, using 20 parts, can we calculate 2 parts? Into 2 will give you answer. If 20 parts is equal to 46,780, 2 parts ends with? 2 parts ends with 8, right? Yes or no? To get 4 parts, you have to take 2 times of that. Yes. That means answer should end with 6. How many are there? How many are there? Either first one or third one. Now 20 parts is equal to 46,780. What is 2 parts? Me, pade. 4, 6, 7, 8. Which is less than 5,000? If two parts is less than 5,000, four parts can never be more than 10,000.
Yes.
Hence, first cannot be the one. Third final answer. Followed?